Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate. Blind.
Such menial tasks.
Still strolling around Baragos, exploring everything that there is to be seen.
Something on your mind?
We've heard that one before. Anything in this barrel? Nope. Look at it. A sack of something. 3 gold. Thank you.
Something on your mind?
We're gonna talk about this fire wine.
Yep. No problem at all.
What?
Yeah. She's pretty handy to have around, our buddy here.
Such menial tasks.
A long sword. Sweet.
What you want?
Another menial task.
You can count on me.
Yeah, fine.
Not getting in that one, at least not yet. I know, a bunch of petty thieves around here, but it's for the cause.
A simple matter.
Thunderhammer Smithy. Sure. We'll check it out. Maybe I'll actually buy some of the crap we've been gathering. There's the smith himself.
Such menial tasks.
Speak up! Speak up!
Jeez, impatient. Hello, friend. What can I do for you this day? No need to trouble yourself. I'm just browsing about your smithy. I've heard much about it. Oh, it's no trouble at all. You can expect nothing but the best in service from the Thunderhammer Smithy. Best armors in the land. If you need some help, don't hesitate to speak to Taram himself. We've heard of this Taram, I think. Alright, so he's not... Okay, so there's smiths and then there's a master smith. Got it. I thought he was the smith.
Speak up! Speak up!
I don't think we can get in any of these areas. I don't think they would like that very much. Another smith.
Speak up! Speak up!
Alright then. Terum Furum. How do you say that?
Kiss me, blarmy. What you wish done?
Oh, he's a little friendlier. Hello there. Is there anything I can do for you in this fair day? Could you show us what you have for sale? That would be a yes. I should give that dagger to Imowen. It's all this leather armor and long sword. And this short sword. Yeah. Oh, this mace is something special. So I should identify that first. Oh, she does have a dagger. Wait, this is unselected. Wait, that's selected. Wait a second. Hold up. I would tell him.
I can make whatever you wish for a wee little bit more than me competition.
Oh, very good. I wasn't sure if that was selected or not, so I wanted to make sure it was unselected. Isle gem, 20 gold pieces. And a sunstone gem for 12. Sweet. I love the jingle of coin. It's awesome. You know what? Before I forget...
What name. Is it?
Good to go?
Didn't mean to do that. There we go. Okay, I have throwing daggers, but maybe something for when they close in on range. Alright, so that's... These are plus one arrows. That's done, I got those. Alright, awesome. See if we saw anything else interesting.
No problem at all.
What?
I can make whatever you wish for a wee little bit more than me competition.
What that? Barul's retort, plus one. The only thing dwarven warriors love more than a cool pint of ale is a short-hafted blade of cold steel. Perfect for penetrating the thick skulls of orcs, these axes serve equally well when thrown or held in one hand. Okay, this isn't a special item description, this is just general... Yeah, like the throwing axe? No, this axe is different. The hand axe or throwing axe is also known as a hatchet. The axe blade has a sharp steel tip counterbalanced by a pointed fluke. The short handle has a point on the bottom and the head may have a spike on top. The most common version of the battle axe is a stout pole about 4 feet in length with a single-edged trumpet-shaped blade mounted on one end. Battle axes are also called broad axes. Okay. Yeah, I just want to look at these simple descriptions. Most clubs are stout hardwood sticks, narrow at the grip and wider at the end. This simple weapon has been used since people first began using tools. Anyone can find a good stout piece of wood and swing it, hence the club's widespread use. Well, anyone can use it except for a mage. One D six. So maybe I should get Imowen a club. I think I'll get her a club actually. For closing in. Yeah, she does have more hit points than us currently.
I can make whatever you wish for a wee little bit more than me competition.
We have flail also. She can't use that. The flail is a sturdy wooden handle attached to an iron rod, a wooden rod with spikes or a spiked iron ball. Between the handle and its implement is either a hinge or chain link. This weapon was originally used as a tool for threshing grain. Really? Is that true? It's pretty interesting. And a mace we've seen. Morning Star. She can't use this, Emmerwin. The Morning Star is a wooden shaft topped with a metal head covered by a spiked iron sheath. Morning Stars have an overall length of about 4 feet. Some have a round, oval, or cylindrical shaped head studded with spikes. Extending from most Morning Star heads, regardless of design, is a long point for thrusting. How about a composite longbow? Oh, she can't use that. Composite bows are long bows or short bows whose staves are made from more than one type of material. This gives greater flexibility and makes arrows fired from this bow deliver more damage. These were developed after the normal longbow. So there's not a lot of classes that can actually use this. It might as well tell us who this is usable by, rather than who not. The longbow is similar to the short bow, except that the staff is about as tall as the archer is, usually 6 to 6.5 feet. It has a better range and accuracy than the short bow, but a slower speed factor. Thief can't use it. Let's buy her a club. Also got halberd. I'm just looking at these guys. I'm not buying. Just by far the oldest and most often used pole arm, the halberd consists of a cleaver-like axe handle mounted on a staff averaging 6 feet in length. The axe blade is balanced at the rear with a fluke and surmounted by a sharp spike, usually of quadrangular design. The fluke is sometimes rebalanced by a hook used to dismount cavalry. A halberd can be best described as a cross between a spear and an axe. Warhammer. Mounted knights cannot effectively use long pole weapons while on horseback, and as a result, many weapons have been fitted with shorter shafts so they may be wielded with just one hand. Maces and flails are two examples of this. The warhammer is another. The horseman's warhammer is a descendant of the Lucerne hammer. It is made entirely of steel with rondels protecting and strengthening the grip. I think I've read this, actually. Rondels are small discs of metal often shaped into decorative design. The shaft is about 18 inches long. Quarterstaff, like what I have. The simplest and humblest of staff weapons, the quarterstaff is a length of wood ranging 6 to 9 feet in length. High-quality quarter staves are made of stout oak and are shod with metal at both ends. The quarterstaff must be wielded with both hands. There's a plus one version of it. Bastard sword, also known as the half and a half sword. I've never heard that. The bastard sword derives its name from the fact that it is halfway between the two-handed sword and the long sword. Oh, really? Is that true? I always wondered why it was called that. The bastard sword has a double-edged blade and a long grip, which can accommodate both hands if preferred. The overall length of the bastard sword ranges between 4 feet and 4 feet 10 inches. Heavy crossbow. Who can use this? Can we? Thief cannot use. A crossbow is a bow mounted crosswise on a wooden or metal shaft, the latter called a tiller. The bow is usually made of ash or yew. The crossbow fires a quarrel, also called a bolt. We've got special arrows here. Here's bolts. Ammunition fired by crossbows regardless of the weapon's size. Oh, I hope you guys don't mind this. I find it interesting to read about such things. Chainmail is made of interlocking metal rings. It is always worn over a layer of padded fabric or soft leather to prevent chafing and can lessen the impact of blows. Split mail is a variant of banded mail in which the metal strips are applied vertically to the backing of chain, leather, or cloth rather than horizontally as in banded mail. Since the body does not swivel in mid-torso as much as it flexes back to front, splint mail is more restrictive in battle. This class of open-faced helmet made of reinforced leather or metal covers most of the head, save the face and neck. These helmets commonly provide protection for the nose. Protects against critical hits. Well, I guess I'm getting critical hits, because I cannot wear that. Leather armor, is that right about? Yeah, I read about that. Plate mail. Combination of chain armor with metal plates covering the vital areas such as the chest, abdomen, and groin. Similar in construction to bronze plate mail, true plate mail comprises chain and leather. Excuse me. Hold on a second. A small shield is usually round and is carried on the forearm, gripped with a shield hand. Its lightweight as compared to a medium shield permits the user to carry other items in that hand, although she cannot wield or carry another weapon. Requires 4 strength. Medium shield. Carried in the same manner as a small shield. Unlike the small shield, however, its weight prevents the character from using her shield hand for anything other than carrying the medium shield. Medium shields are usually made of metal, range from 3 to 4 feet in diameter, and can be of any shape, from round to square to a dragon's spread wings. I think I might have read this description. A typical medieval shield resembles a triangle with one point facing downward. And a large shield. The body shield, also known as the kite or tower shield, is a massive metal or wooden shield reaching nearly from the chin to the toe of the user. It must be firmly fastened to the forearm, and the shield hand must firmly grip it at all times. Naturally, this precludes the use of the shield hand for anything but holding the body shield in place. So you get armor class +1 and an extra +1 versus missile attacks. Requires 15 strength. cool. And the buckler, also known as a target shield, is a small round shield of wood or metal that fastens to the forearm. Because of its size, it is light and can be worn with very light restriction to movement. Full plate armor? Full plate armor is the best armor a warrior can buy, both in appearance and protection. The perfectly fitted interlocking plates are specially angled to deflect arrows and blows, and the entire suit is carefully adorned with rich engraving and embossed detail. So this one has armor class 1 and minus 3, so I guess it's, yeah, improving versus slashing and 2 versus piercing and missile. Requires 15 strength. The weight alone is 70. I'm guessing that's pounds. I'm not even look at this special stuff. I can't afford it. Alright. I guess we're done. Oh, I can ask him stuff? Oh, can I identify this? Or I can wait and buy the spell. Let's wait. Alright, so we got stuff. There you go. I'll sell her dagger too, why not? Free up an inventory slot. I've got a dagger myself. 1d4. 1d6. Yeah, let's get rid of the daggers.
I can make whatever you wish for a wee little bit more than me competition.
They're only 1 gold, but... Free up weight and an inventory slot. We're done in here. Jeez, about half the episode.
Fine.
Take a walk back down here. We've been down here. Yeah, just gonna clear out the fog of war over there. Is this anything? There's one thing that's still tricky, is finding entrances. You can go in places. The tab does not reveal that.
Yeah, mate.
Seem to get in any of these either. So Thunderhammer Smithy. I guess we'll head up this road here. Past the Red Sheaf Inn again. I checked that, yeah.
Hello, mate. You look a friendly face.
You're not saying anything different.
Yeah?
I cannot talk now. My children are waiting for me at home. Not good to leave them alone for long, but both the husband and me must look for a way to keep gold coming in. Hard to keep food on the table when there is no work to be had. That's pretty unfortunate. Ooh. Another dagger to replace the one we just sold, and 5 gold. I'm just walking through people's backyards. We've been in here, in that one. But there's also this. Marianne looks like she's ready for battle.
Such menial tasks. Salutations.
My husband had to make a sudden business trip to Arm, and I'm so worried for him. Marianne, he always said. Marianne, who knows the road better than old Roe? But the highways just aren't as safe as they once were, and there hasn't been a messenger for Arm here in months. Could you keep your eyes open along the southern roads and let me know if you find anything? Marianne. I was moved by the pleas of Marianne of Baragos today. Her husband, Roe, had to make a trip south of Arm, and she is understandably worried for his safety. I have sworn to keep my eyes open for any news of relevance I might encounter in my journeys down that road. I guess I might come back here quite a few times. Come back here. Oh, she's pacing. Have anything else to say?
Salutations.
Take care of yourself out there, friend. Okay. Don't mind if we help ourselves to whatever you might have.
A simple matter.
At all so far.
Something up? Gotcha.
Do your trick. Ooh, History of the Chosen of Mistra. Cool.
Yes, fine. What is fine?
I thought I had them both highlighted.
What? A simple matter.
There we go.
Fine. Such menial tasks.
Chosen of Mistra in Marianne's residence. You know, I should start writing down, because I'm going to be reading these books. Mithra. What's her name? Marianne?
Fine.
Where is she? I wasn't looking. Oh, there she is. So, Marianne. Alright. I'll be reading this stuff. That goes out.
A simple matter.
How north do we go? We're almost at the end. We'll be checking out that house in a bit. Hmm. This fence bars our way. How rude.
Speak up, speak up!
What's this?
Hurry up!
You hurry up.
Gotcha.
Got it.
Yes? Fine.
Carl and Jürgen.
Fine.
I should have joined the army.
I advise you to be on your best behavior while in this house. I'll be watching you very closely. Jürgen says, aye, we've our eyes on you. Okay. Best you watch your step in here, stranger. A word from Mr. Travenhurst and you're gutted like a trout. Like a trout, Jürgen says. Okay, Jürgen doesn't talk for himself. He just answers when Carl does. Well, I guess he won't let us open this then. He'll gut us like a trout. Gerard Travenhurst. Greetings.
Away with you, beggar.
Oh, I'm not a beggar. Hold your place. No need for us to get off on the wrong foot. I rather like company occasionally, but most of the townsfolk are a bit standoffish. I cannot understand why, sir. You've a lovely home and seem quite amiable. Perhaps it is because of those two guards you employ? That is an unfortunate possibility. They do seem to take a touch too much pleasure from their positions, but I'd sooner have them than not. I doubt I should feel safe without them, what with the banditry rampant about the countryside. Mayhaps when things have settled I can maintain a more open house. Leave me, please. As a member of the town council, there is much that weighs on my mind. I don't suppose you'll let us look at your books, will you? History of Kalimshan? He doesn't care. Okay. History of the North 1. Good, we're missing that one. Empty. History of the North 4. Do we have them all now? Assuming there is just 4. Look at all the books we have. Here's 2. 5. 1. So far we're missing 3 and 4. I mean, no. 2 and 3. Oh no, 2. Okay. Yeah, it is 3 and 4 we're missing. There's 4. We're missing 3. Alright. Mind if we do. Seven. Okay, we go on for quite a bit. I don't dare go in that one with them standing there. It's gonna be more like coin in there. More books!
Such menial tasks.
I love this place. History of Shadowdale 1. And 2. And 3. We're full.
Yep. Gotcha.
Not gonna be able to carry all this crap. Four. 5. Holy crap. Six. All in order, too. Seven. Nothing in those of note. Gank in there. He's got some good locks in here. This, however, gold necklace and a wand. Sweet. So we need to identify this, but the general description of wands. Wands are 1 1/4 feet long and slender. They are made of ivory, bone, or wood, and usually tipped with something, metal, crystal, stone, and so on. They are fragile and tend to break easily. Because of this, they are often kept in cases. Wands are powered by charges, each use costing 1 or more charges, depending on the item. When a wand runs out of charges, it is consumed and destroyed. Now, yeah, a thief can't use it in a D&D, huh? Oh, in some systems. Oh, she's slowed. We need more party members to carry this crap. Empty. Well, at least got experience for it.
What is such menial tasks?
I am not weighed down.
What you want?
Didn't mean to do that. Just put the belt on. Doesn't seem like a good idea. Am I gonna lose something? Hold on. See if I can drop something on the floor.
Fine.
Do I lose it forever? I guess I lost it forever. That's why I didn't want to do that. The dagger's 1 gold, screw it. Just need an extra slot to be able to maneuver this crap around. She's overweight. The heaviest thing is probably the mace. 10. I don't know why I'm carrying around this skull. I just am. Okay, so now she's not overweight. Neither am I.
A simple matter? What? Such menial tasks.
We need more party members. Do I look here? If I did, there was nothing.
Such menial tasks.
Alright, so I got a lot of books. A lot to read. Many videos coming up.
Fine.
There's a farmer. I guess we'll call it an episode. I'm guessing that the rest of this place will take at least another episode to get through, so I'll meet you guys back then, and thanks so much for watching, as always, and always, seek adventure.